that strong point.
Any minute now. Stand by. Let's give it them back for Dunkirk.
Do you hear that, but Jesus, Dunkirk? Did you hear it, Clough? Sure, he was still at school at the time. Come on, you bastard! Come out, you dusty slobs! Letting it back!
G'day, guys. So that's actual footage of Pete landing on the beach at D-Day. Yeah, as you can tell, it started off really well for him. For those that don't know me, my name's Richard. I organised the first trip in 2008. I went again in 2014 and returning this year. I thought, carrying on from what Caroline's been doing for us all, I thought I'd narrow it down a little bit for Aussies and what we need to consider. First one's your visas. So for your visas, I know a lot of guys have already done it, but if you haven't, Google ESTA application, E-S-T-A application, and it should be the first one that pops up. There's a lot of sites out there that will try and charge you extra. You shouldn't be being charged more than about $20, and make sure it's got a government website address in there, not some .com one. It should be .gov. Another one for you all is travel insurance. I know it can be expensive for those that have credit cards. Check your credit cards. There could be complimentary insurance in there. You save yourself a bit of coin. Just make sure that it covers off on things like sports, because as seen in the past, there has been a couple of injuries with Aussies in at D-Day. Traveling with your tanks, make sure you take the regulator out. Security in the US is pretty tight. We all lost bottles in 2008. You must take the reg out. The reason for that is so that customs, if they find it, they can look inside. When they x-ray them, they can't see inside the bottle because they're lined with aluminium. What to do and what not to do at the field. Do not rock up with a carload of fireworks. I'll say that again. Do not rock up with a carload of fireworks. This happened in 2008. Very, very funny, but it took a bit of serious negotiation with Dwayne, the field owner, to let us dispose of them. But yeah, don't rock up with a carload of fireworks. Drugs, don't rock up with drugs. It's a family event, which is a bit different for us Aussies, because here in Australia you rock up and it's most blokes in there from 20 onwards, whereas in New Zealand, not New Zealand, in America there'll be guys that are about, you know, 10 upwards, so don't make a fool of yourself. That leads into antisocial behaviour. They have a zero tolerance for it over there, so if you want to carry on like a pork chop and you know, what engage in what others might consider antisocial behavior, go and do it somewhere else. Yeah, we've all had a few drinks and everything at the field. There will be a couple of nights where we all have some good drinks and good times, but just don't go overboard with it. Another thing, everyone's banging on about hydrate. Okay, most of that comes down to fitness. If you're not very active, start getting active. The field is very rough in areas. Our first year there, we had a bloke break his ankle or do all the tendons in his ankle. Was it last year, the year before, Tim ended up in the back of an ambulance. I'm not saying that this is because people are unfit, but it does get very hot there, and having a bit of conditioning, getting used to kind of working out and being in hot and stressful conditions will make it a little bit easier. If you're very active, great. Start working out in the middle of the day, because we're coming into winter, it's going to start cooling off. Expose yourself to hot conditions and be used to it. Alcohol is going to sap a lot of water out of us. Make sure you hydrate with that, and don't expect to sink a heap of alcohol and then be running around like a madman the next day. Eating as well. Make sure you eat right over there. American meals are big, full of calories. Just make sure they're good calories. Don't expect to down a burger and then run a mile the next day, because you'll probably have a good upchuck and you'll probably be hungover as well. Alright. One thing, guys like to get a little bit of Australia, so if you've got stuff you want to trade or take as gifts, do so. It goes down a treat, and you'll end up with coming home with some great stuff as well. The Germans, this is one thing that really took me back the first time I was there. They take this shit serious. They're very social, they're very, very funny, but you've got to announce yourself when you go into their camp. Don't just roll in going, "Hey fellas, how you going?" Announce yourselves, because there are some shenanigans. Our first year there, they tried to nick our kangaroos, they tried to nick flags, they tried to, and we do it to them as well. It's all for a bit of harmless fun, a bit of banter, but just make sure you announce yourselves when you go into their camps. Otherwise, they get very suspicious and very jumpy. Vendors. Rock up with an empty gear bag. If the vendors are half as good as they were last time, you'll expect to walk away with some good bargains, some stuff to fill out your kit bags, some new exciting stuff. If you intend on bringing it home, make sure it's legal, or that you've got the right paperwork to bring it back into Australia. Engage with them, get to know them. They might loan you some new stuff to try out. They might give you a discount. If Tyler Tiberius is there, he'll probably still be hungover from the first time he went there. Good dude, a lot of fun. Have fun, enjoy yourself. Feel as though you're obliged to stay at the field all the time. If you want to go off and do some other things, go and do it. I myself will probably be taking off for a night, going up to Missouri, I think it is, I'm not sure, and catching up with a mate that I met at the first D-Day, or hopefully we can bring him down and he can catch up with everyone. If you've got any questions, hit me up. I know there's a lot of first time Aussies going this year. Hit us up, ask a silly question. We'll try and find out. If I don't know it, Pete will know it. If Pete doesn't know it, someone else will. Have fun. Introduce yourself to everyone. Don't make a dick of yourself. As I said in one of Caroline's videos, if you make a dick of yourself, you're pretty much going to be persona non grata, especially at the hotel. That woman has worked damn hard to get us a good rate at the hotel. Make sure we don't ruin it for next year, or people that continue to go, because Caroline's worked tirelessly to give us a good rate, and let's not burn it for her or for others. On that, if you're staying at the hotel, take something for this event coordinator that's been working with her. She'll appreciate it, and hey, if you get people on side and you've got a bit of an issue, they're more likely to help you out. Alright, so hopefully these videos, people find them handy. If you don't, that's fine. If you do, give us a like. If you've got any questions or issues, let me know. The plan is to keep doing little updates as we get closer to D-Day, and on the way there, and a little video every day while I'm there. I've just bought myself a 360 camera, so if you've got ideas on how to play with that, let us know. I've already hit Joel up. We're going to mount it in one of the tanks. We'll put it in the camp one day during the officers' tea party and something like that. Any ideas, let me know. Alrighty fellas, that's about it. I'm starting to waffle, so I'll let you go. Any dramas, questions, queries, doubtful points, let me know. See ya.